Hello, everybody, and welcome to the channel. It's Paulie Esther here, and this is my second channel, Paulie Pops, where I make videos about my hobby of collecting Funko Pops. So today, we got this massive motherload of a box from Popcultcha. You can see here by the tape, that green tape is the Popcultcha tape. This says it's a case of 36 Super Saiyan Goku, but it's not. It is a case of 36. However, oh man, this is a motherload. All right, so Popcultcha is a company that I love ordering from in Australia. I've ordered from them several times and I've had a great experience every time. And so somebody told me that they had this offer here on their website for a mystery box. And it's a case of 36 Funko Poplandia Mystery Box Warehouse to the Public 2020 box of 36 pop vinyl figures. And it has, these are in US prices just to keep everything simple. Even though I'm in Canada, I just thought I'll put all the prices in US just for reasons which will become clear later on. So this is originally priced, suggested retail value of $557 US, marked $400 down for the low, low price of $155. Now it says free shipping here, but that's only within Australia. I'm in Canada, so I had to pay an additional $80 shipping for this, which isn't unreasonable given the weight of this box. And then I also had to pay customs $25 in duty taxes to receive this. So all in, I am $260 into this box of 36 pops, which isn't bad for 36 pops, honestly. So we're gonna see what we get in here. The description reads as Funko Poplandia Mystery Box Warehouse to Public 2020 box of 36 pop vinyl figures. Can't make it to Geelong. I don't know how to pronounce this. I apologize for the people in Australia that I'm butchering the name of your city. Can't make it to the Popcultcha Warehouse to Public event. Fear not, as we've thrown together a massive box of savings that'll deliver straight to your door. Included in our Warehouse to Public Mystery Box are 36 unique pop vinyl figures picked from the range in our warehouse. What are they? Who knows? You'll have to purchase one to find out, but at a savings of over $500 off of the original suggested retail price, how could you resist? Join in the festivities of our biennial warehouse event and grab this box of bargains for your pop collection. Please note, this mystery box is prepackaged and blind boxed, so there's no way of knowing or requesting what you might get. Due to the way these boxes have been packed, we can't guarantee that those ordering more than one box won't receive an identical set of 36. As these items are heavily discounted, all sales on this mystery box are final, and we cannot guarantee mint boxes and cannot replace items that may arrive with slight box damage. No further discounts can be used with this mystery box, including your Popcultcha pennies. Proudly brought to you by Popcultcha, Australia's largest and most comprehensive pop vinyl online store. That is very true. The reason I love ordering from Popcultcha is they get a lot of the store exclusives in the United States that I am unable to get here in Canada. And rather than jumping through hoops ordering from all these different places like Entertainment Earth, Box Lunch, Target, etc., I can usually get everything I want from Popcultcha all in one shot. So they are my source for exclusives. Now, they don't have the special store stickers on them. They have those special edition stickers, but I don't care. I'm collecting figures, I'm not collecting stickers. What's gonna be in here? I don't know. We are going to open it up. I also have a contest, well, a bet of sorts going on with the Husky Swordsman and the King to see who gets the best figure in here. Now, I completely expect that this is going to be a warehouse dump. They're going to be selling, they're going to be putting things that they cannot sell into this box. So I'm just hoping that I get enough things that I'm interested in to cover my initial value, my initial purchase price of $260. I'd love to get $260 worth of value of things I want out of it. More than that is gravy. Whoever gets the best pop wins the bet and owes the other, the top person, the value of their best pop, I believe. Yes, so say, let's say that King, for example, gets a $50 pop. My best pop in here is valued at $30 according to the pop price guide. I owe him 30 bucks. So this box might cost me even more than my 260. Okay, so we are going to cut this open. I'm not going to peek. I'm going to just show them all to the camera one by one, 36 times. And then afterwards, I'll turn off the camera, sort them all by value, and we'll go through a pop price guide on the Funko app and see what they come out at for lowest to highest pops. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to carefully cut this. I don't know how close the pops are to the top of this tape, so I don't want to cut any of the tops. So we're going to be super careful opening this up. I'm going to try not to peek. Oh, okay. So they're individual cases inside. Huh. Interesting. Give me a minute. Okay, so what we wound up with is six cases of six in here. So that's 36. So we got six of these to open. Makes it a little bit easier to do this. So we'll just open these individual boxes one at a time. And I'll just put them all off to the side as we show them to the camera. And then, as I said, we'll just determine values at the end. So, I like that these are all double boxed, obviously. Helps protect them in transit. Again, this is a warehouse clear out. There's no guarantee of any condition or anything like that. So we have no idea what we're going to get. So just one at a time, we're going to show them the camera. I'm hoping to get some... before I show you this. Here, I have not peeked yet. We should look at the reviews. Because another thing that had me interested in this were the reviews. So where's the reviews? Here we go. Okay. Best box ever. Convention pops. Flocked pops. Vaulted. Best value ever. Great selection as well. Couldn't be happier. Even one pop I had been looking for and I couldn't find was in the box. Fantastic pop culture. 5 stars. Posted by Peter. Mystery box. Extremely good value for the money. I expect to pull special editions and even convention exclusives when opening this box. I kept about 90% of the pops I pulled. Great mystery box and came in mint condition. 5 stars. Epic box. Wow. The best mystery box I have ever purchased. I was very happy with the pops I received. Got a few special editions and some Marvel ones I wanted. Thanks, Pop Culture. Okay, so these are pretty good reviews. Let's see how I feel about this by the end. Again, I have low expectations, so I would love to be surprised. All right, opening this up again. Box number one of six. 36 pops to go through here. Pull out this first pop. Where's the front? And what do we get? Oh, Wizard Deadpool. That's actually pretty cool. I don't collect Marvel, but that's a... I wouldn't say that's a miss. I like that one. I like Deadpool. Deadpool's 30th anniversary is fun. Deadpool's a very good character. In demand, I would say. Second pop is... Homer Simpson, Grim Reaper Homer. This is from the Treehouse of Horror set. I have this one. I don't think it's a bad pop, though. So, that's not terrible for me. I like all the Simpson pops, but sadly, I already have it. Next pop. Ooh, okay. So, this is a Silver Age All Might. This is a special edition. This is an exclusive somewhere from Hero Academia. I don't collect anime, but it's a special edition, so I'm hopeful that that has some value. Don't know. Next one. Beers from Captain Marvel. Okay, that's going to be a dud. All of the Captain Marvel pops were on clearance. That's definitely going to be a dud in the price guide. Next. Mr. Hankey from South Park. I don't have any South Park pops. I'm not upset about that. I'm pretty happy about that one, honestly. I was thinking about getting the South Park pops. And finally, for the first box, we got... Okay, this is DC's Bombshell series. This did not sell very well. I don't have it. It's Wonder Woman. It's not a terrible pop, but I don't expect it's going to have a lot of value. All right, let's move on to box number two. This is going to be interesting. Going to be a mixed bag of everything, it looks like. Okay. Case number two, first pop. Ooh, the genie from the live action Aladdin. So this is the Will Smith version of that. I don't have that pop. I'm not upset about that one either. All right, we're doing okay. We're doing okay. Keep it going. Keep it going. No duds. Let's see. Black Panther Marvel Studios. This is one of the gold editions. Again, I don't collect Marvel, but this is not, you know, a terrible pop. Black Panther, obviously, we're all sad to see the loss of Chadwick Boseman. I'm definitely going to keep this one. They did a lot of gold versions of all of the Avengers characters. That's a cool one. Oh, I took a peek. This is the one I saw anyway, so. This is a Sheriff Woody with Forky. I don't have this one. I have a Woody, but mine is like the 25th anniversary of Toy Story. So with Forky, I'm going to keep that one. I like that too. All right, we're doing pretty good. I'm pretty happy so far. Keep it going. Next. South Park Awesome-O Special Edition. So this is... okay, so the most recent South Park figures, they did them in Halloween costume, and they had a full Awesome-O here. You can see it on the back here with the box part of the costume. So this is a special edition to somewhere with the unmasked version with the face reveal of Awesome-O. So I'm not upset about that either. I love getting special editions from Popcultcha. I actually held off on, I have a cart full over at Popcultcha right now, but I wanted to wait to see what I get in here because some of the items that I had were convention exclusives and things that they were putting on clearance that were older convention exclusives, and I said I might get some of them in this box, so I wanted to wait to see what I got in here before I put my next order in with Popcultcha. So I feel a sticker on this one. What is this pop? This is... Holy cow! Panda Pool Chase? Blocked? What? I don't even know what this pop is. It says Chase, though. I mean, maybe I'm getting excited over nothing, and this isn't valuable, but that's a cool one. I don't have any Deadpool pops because I don't collect Marvel. Might make a little section of Marvel now with what I'm getting here today. So, let's see. Okay, so last pop in the second case of six is a Flocked Champa from Dragon Ball Z. No, just Dragon Ball. I don't know. I don't know the difference between Dragon Ball and Dragon Ball Z. Don't sue me. I'm sorry. I'm not an anime fan. This is a Flock Special Edition, so I'm not upset at getting Special Editions. There should always be good trade fodder at the very least, right? So, third case. I'm happy so far. I'm eager to see what the values are. That, I don't know. Maybe I'm completely out of my mind, but like I said, I don't collect Marvel. I don't keep up on the values of the Marvel, but... That Panda Pool seems like it's probably the best figure so far. Don't know. All right, next. Here we go. First one out of the third box. Cheers, Woody Boy. That's going to be a dud. I have it, and it's not very valuable. So that's going to be a dud. And next we have... I have all the Cheers pops. Next we have... Ooh, what is this? Mina Ashido, another Hero Academia Special Edition. I mean, I know Hero Academia is very popular. Whenever I go to Hot Topic, there's always people who are grabbing all of the Hero Academia pops. So I know they're going to be popular. And if they're special editions, depending on where they're from, if it's a store that's hard to get pops from in Canada, that might be a good pop for me to use as trade fodder. So I like the special editions. Here we go. Next, Carnage. Wow, that's a cool pop. Again, Marvel. But, I'm very familiar with all of the Marvel properties and comics, so I know all of them. I just don't really like bobblehead, so I don't collect Marvel or Star Wars. But maybe we'll make an exception. Next, we have Randy Marsh, another one of the South Park gang. My South Park collection is filling up here quickly. Gonna fill in some holes to start my South Park characters. Next, we have... Oh, Diane Chambers from Cheers. Sorry, I just missed her so readily. There we go. Diane, I have her too. Yeah, those Cheers pops are on clearance around here too. They're not very expensive. Those are going to be some of the low-end ones in that pop price guide when we get to pricing these. And next we have Buzz Lightyear floating from Toy Story 4. I don't have any of the main characters from Toy Story 4, so I definitely need Buzz. And I'm not upset about that one either. All right, we're halfway through. We got three more cases to go. So we'll do the values, and then I'll realistically say, you know, what value I got out of it or what I'm going to keep, and then judge by that whether this was a good idea for me. But I think right now I'm feeling pretty good about it halfway through. I'm liking it. Oh, stop looking. All right, next we have Himiko Toga from My Hero Academia. Don't know. Don't watch the show. I know it's popular. I know people recommend it. Don't know anything about it. Next. Michael Klump. So this is a special edition from The Office. This is the UK version of The Office. So instead of our Michael Scott that we have in the US version, we have Michael Klump. That's a good pick right there. Next, another South Park. We have Tool Shed. All right, my South Park corner is getting filled up. Next, Locked Bunny. I don't have this one. This is a store exclusive. I feel like this is supposed to have a special edition sticker on it. I'm pretty sure this was Target exclusive. Don't know. But I don't have that pop either. Not upset about that. Next. Princess Jasmine. Okay, this was a live action store exclusive. I think this is a Hot Topic exclusive. If this is the figure I'm thinking of, I think I have it already. Not sure. Maybe not. I think the one I have is her in the streetwear where she's trying to be incognito. She's very dressed up in this one. I might need this figure. I have some Aladdins, but the two Aladdins I got today I do not have. If that's not the one I'm thinking of. Here's another gold Marvel. This is Captain America. That's a cool one. And that's fourth case down. Case number five. Here we go. You want to peek? Can't peek. All right. Case number five. What do we get? What? Glow in the Dark Genie Special Edition. Another Aladdin pop. That's cool. I like that. Yeah, I like that movie. I thought Will Smith did a good job. Of course, nobody could outdo Robin Williams. It'd be a tough act to follow, but I thought Will Smith did very well in that movie. Next, we have another gold one. This is a Black Widow, Marvel Studios gold version. Black Widow. Next. Gabby Gabby with Forky. Okay, I have a regular Gabby Gabby because I picked her up off clearance when all the Toy Story 4 stuff was being blown out. But I don't have this one. Special edition with Forky. Not upset about that either. Happy to round out my Toy Story collection. Next. Another gold one. We got Rocket Raccoon in gold. Wonder if there's any demand for these gold ones. Don't know. Probably not. Let's see. Next. Ooh, okay. So this is a glitter alien. So this is also a special edition. One of the diamond editions, which just means they roll them in glitter. Oh, yeah. It's so sparkly. I don't know if the camera is picking any of that up, but it's completely covered in glitter. Toy Story Diamond Edition Glitter Alien. Don't have that pop either. There's been very few pops that I have, right? Just the Homer and the Cheers ones, I think, are the only ones that I actually have. Now, not that I care about all of them, but I don't have duplicates for my collection by comparison to how many we've opened. Last for this case is Nick Fury. Okay, that's also going to be a dud. As I said, all the Captain Marvel movie figures were blown out. And here we go, last one. So we got, exactly what the reviews have said so far, special editions and flocked. No convention pieces, I don't think. Yeah, they'd have convention stickers on them. They'd just have special edition stickers. They would have convention stickers. So no convention pieces, but we did get what the reviews said with flocked pieces and special editions. So last box, here we go. We got Groot, we can put him next to Rocket. Gold Groot. So what's that? Five of these golds now? Cap. I think so. We got 5 golds. Uh-oh. I peeked. Here's another dud. Yanra Captain Marvel. That's going to be another dud. They can't all be winners, folks. This is inventory clear out. They can't all be winners. Next, Spider-Man Gamerverse Unmasked. That's a nice looking pop. The mask in hands. Don't have that because I don't collect Marvel. And, oh, this is a heavy one. What is this? Oh, look at that. Diamond Edition Genie with the lamp. There's the Robin Williams version. That's a cool pop. Don't have that either. Last two we got. Special edition All for One for My Hero Academia. No idea. This guy looks like he has a face hugger on his face. I don't know anything about this show. Don't know anything. Special edition. Could be promising. And last, don't feel any stickers on it. So this is just going to be some sort of a common pop. And it is Human Kite for South Park. All right, so we had Toolshed, Human Kite, Mr. Hankey, Randy Marsh. This looks like this was a maybe second series of South Park figures. Not sure, but I don't have that either. So we got a lot of variety here. Now I'm going to sort them out by value. We'll look them up and we'll see what's the best and what's the worst. Okay, so I went ahead and looked up all the values. I entered everything in on the app on my phone, the Funko app, which is great. You can just scan the bottom of the barcode and it'll tell you exactly what figure it is. You can add it to your collection and it uses the pop price guide for values. And okay, so we're just gonna start from lowest value to highest. So as predicted, the Captain Marvel movie stuff is on the low end. First off, we have Nick Fury coming in at $6. After that, we have this Himiko Toga from My Hero Academia with the face covering. This is also $6. I will note that over half of the figures were $13 or more, so I think we're doing okay here. Next, the Marvel Gold Chrome Black Widow, $6. Followed by Groot. Marvel Gold Chrome, also $6. Then we have South Park Tool Shed. This one comes in at $7, and there's a big crease here. And I'll note that this is the only figure that received any damage. This was probably in the corner, couldn't be helped. And it's a lower value figure anyway, so big whoop. $7 for that one. And rounding out the first six, we have Gabby Gabby with Forky. This was a Walmart exclusive. That's why it has that special edition sticker. And this comes in at $7. And of this first box, this is the one that is the most desirable to me. I'm keeping that in my collection. $7, I don't care. I am very happy to have that figure. Next, we have Genie from Aladdin as played by Will Smith in the live action movie. That one comes in at $7. Then we have the other South Park figure here, Human Kite. This one comes in at $8. Another gold chrome Marvel figure. This one's Rocket. That one's also $8. Then we have the Genie, the glow-in-the-dark Genie. Also, again, Will Smith live-action movie. This has the special edition sticker as well as the glow-in-the-dark sticker. This is an Amazon exclusive. That one comes in at $8. Both of these I'm very pleased to have. I don't have those in my collection. And the glow-in-the-dark Genie is really cool too. So $8 for the glow-in-the-dark. And then we have the final two Captain Marvel figures. As I said, I didn't predict that these would be worth very much. We have Veers, Carol Danvers, Veers. That one's $8. And Jan Rog is also $8. I'm a little skeptical on the values of those because I think you can still pick those up at clearance, but they book at $8 each. Next, we got Grim Reaper Homer from the Simpsons Treehouse of Horror Collection. I already have this, otherwise this would be a great pull for me. $9. Unfortunately, I also already have this figure too. This isn't the one I was thinking of. This is the Princess Jasmine in the Desert Moon outfit. This is a Hot Topic exclusive and it books for $9. I'd be over the moon about this if I didn't already have it. I think I can get that on clearance at my Hot Topic still, if I'm being honest. But it's a nice figure. Next we have Woody Boyd from Cheers and Diane Chambers from Cheers. These both book at $11. I'm a little skeptical on the book value of those. but I think I can get those on clearance at EV Games, but gotta go by the book value, right? Now we start to get into the ones that are $13 or more. Everything else is gonna be $13 or more from here on out. So we have the Michael Klump. This is Ricky Gervais' UK version of The Office. Office Pops are hot. Not sure about the UK version, but this is Michael Klump, Ricky Gervais, GameStop exclusive, $13. And then we have the Dragon Ball Flocked Champa figure here. This was a Hot Topic special edition figure exclusive, $13 for that one too. Next we have Woody holding Forky. This is a Hot Topic exclusive. That one's valued at $13. Don't have that. Happy to have that one. And this is a Target exclusive Flocked Bunny. Kind of odd it doesn't have the special edition sticker. Did the Woody have special edition sticker? Neither of these have the special edition sticker, but they are exclusives. So they just they missed stickering, I guess. So the Flocked Bunny Target exclusive is also $13. Happy to have both of those. I would have picked them up had I seen them. And this is another one of the Marvel Gold Chrome. That's the Black Panther, and he's valued at $14. Here's the My Hero Academia All for One. This is a Big Apple Comics exclusive. I remember seeing this on their website because I was looking for the Brainiac and the Black Adam Big Apple Comics exclusives, and they had that on there too. All for One, that one books in at $14 for that exclusive. Then another My Hero Academia exclusive is this Metallic Silver Age All Might. This is a Barnes & Noble exclusive, and that one books in at $15. Again, these are all U.S. prices just to keep everything simple. And we have the Genie from the animated version of Aladdin as played by Robin Williams. Genie with the Lamp, this is the Diamond Edition. This is a Hot Topic exclusive, and that one books at $15. Happy to have that one. Next, we have the Mina Ashido Special Edition. This is a GameStop exclusive. This is the metallic version, and Mina Ashido is worth $16. And now we have the Wonder Woman Bombshells Edition. And what I didn't notice until I looked this up on the price guide is that this is the special holiday edition that was exclusive to Michaels. Again, no special edition sticker here, but you can see Wonder Woman is dressed in red and green. So this is the holiday version of this figure. Exclusive to Michaels, $16. Then we have Wizard Deadpool. This is also a $16 figure. And finally, no, I guess we have one more South Park after this. South Park Mr. Hankey, that's a $16 one. Happy to have that one. Last of the gold chrome Marvel figures, we have Captain America. This one comes in at $17. And we finish off this round of six here with Carnage. This is a Hot Topic exclusive figure, and Carnage books at $18. I think that one has some potential because, you know, the villains in Marvel are pretty decent sometimes. Okay, final six. Now we get into the very most expensive of the figures. We start out here with Buzz Lightyear Floating. This is an Amazon exclusive figure, and that one books in at $19. Then we have the Diamond Glitter Toy Story Alien Special Edition. This was a Hot Topic exclusive. That one books at $20. Happy to have both of those for my Toy Story collection. Then we have the Spider-Man Gamerverse. This is the white spider on the suit. That's also a $20 figure. And then we have Awesomeo Unmasked. This is Cartman pulling the prank as the robot. And this is special edition. This was a For Your Entertainment exclusive figure. That one books in at $23. And then our final two figures here, we have Randy Marsh from South Park. And this one books at $32? Really? I double checked it. $32 for Randy Marsh. I knew some of the South Park figures had some value, which is why I haven't tried to put that collection together. But now we're going to start picking away at it. And drumroll please, the very most expensive figure in the price guide from this batch of figures is Pandapool. This is a special edition. This is the Hot Topic exclusive. And we got the Chase, which is Flocked. Was that a mistake? Was this supposed to be just regular Pandapool? And this book's at $60. So top that, King and Husky Swordsman. See if you can pull out a figure that's worth more than $60 in the price guide from your two boxes. And that's the what the bet is determined upon. So now we're going to add everything up and see what the total value is and compare it to what I paid, etc., yada, yada, yada. Wow, so we wound up hitting exactly double on this. Adding it all up, total value in the price guide of these figures is $520. All told, all in, even paying $25 for duty to customs and $80 for shipping, my total cost was $260, so we doubled up. Did I get personal value to cover my $260 here? I think so. There are a lot of figures here that I really don't have that much interest in, like the My Hero Academia stuff that I'll be looking to pass on to another collector. But given that they are special editions and some of that stuff is hot in my area, I think I can probably do a local swap or a trade or sell them off to get some value back out of them there. So overall, I'm really happy with what we pulled out of here. I think I'm probably going to win the bet with that Panda Pool Flock Chase at $60. I'll be very surprised if Husky Swordsman or the King are able to pull a figure out that's valued more than that. If they put videos up on their channels, I will link them in the description so you can check out and see what they got. But overall, I'm very happy. I didn't get any of those convention exclusives that I was hoping that maybe Popcultcha was going to part with and put into these mystery boxes. But hey, they're saved in my cart and we'll leave it for another day. I'm going to be ready to go for another order with Popcultcha because I love them. So I think they do a great job. And yeah, I guess that's all I have to say. Thank you so very much for watching. It was a lot of fun opening these up and seeing what we get here live on camera. So appreciate you all. Have a great day. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.